So in this video, we try to go with that other SQL interview question where we generally get that wildcard search. So wildcard search means where name start with some vowel or not start or start with some specific character, or maybe second character belongs to this or last character belongs to only a specific set of characters. So those type of questions generally come under wildcard search. So we try to cover a lot more, whatever I put here, 4 questions, but we'll try to go through that many more questions and try to understand how we can achieve those first character, second character, third character, or last character, or belongs to any set. How? So now we will move to SQL Server and try to understand that how it's going to work. So I created one temp table and I inserted here value. So if you can go and see it here, now it's insert, it's displaying all those values here. So now we'll remove this first so that we have enough space. And now we have this table. So these are that value we have. Now first question is start where we can get that only start with vowels. So now second, third, fourth, fifth. It's not need to come at seventh one. In this one first one. So now let's go and try to write that our first statement. So what we can do, select the start from start name where name like, okay, first thing like operator. Now so like operator, to do any character search we use that percentile. Just to start with any or end with any, we can put like this one. So it will search everything, whatever is there in that name. And now suppose now here we wanted to start with vowels. So first character will be vowel. So suppose this one will be vowel and second one need to be anything apart from this. Or maybe this, we not bother about those. So now I can put that percentile. So what it will do, anything on second position, it will take care of this. So now for first one, since it's vowel, what we can do, we can put that this bracket, open close bracket, then we can put that A, E, I, O, U. Like this, we can put that, okay? And then we can do that search. So if we now, if I go ahead and run this one, so you can see, only it came that name start with that A, we don't have any name start with E, I, O, U. It's only displaying that name start with that A. Okay. So I hope you got this how. And now we'll go and try to understand second. Might be you will understand there. So now that not start with that vowel. So now what we need to do, we just need to copy this one, paste it here now. Not start, what we can do? We can put this symbol just like a cap. So what it's going to consider, it will consider it's not belongs to any of these elements, whatever we put inside that bracket. Only for that first letter, right? And from second one, anything will be possible. So now if I comment it on this one, if I run this. Now we see, we're not getting whatever we got in first time, like with this, vowel start with A. Now first and sixth one is not displaying. So we got that five output, which are not starting with AEIUU, that name we got it. So now similarly, if we go ahead and comment it out this as well. Third question is that, how we can get that where name, second name is Bob. Okay. So now we need to go ahead and see that which of second character is Bob. So now what we need to do, we need to put that one underscore on the first place and then in the second one, whatever it belongs to this one. So now if I go ahead and run that, we can see Rakesh, again we got that 5. But since that region behind that second letter is A, I, O, A and O, that's why it's coming in this, all of them are same. 5 we got that, okay? So in this way, we can get now, suppose in place of second, now I need on third position. If I go ahead and run that, we are not getting any output. Sorry, my bad. Okay, so now we got that. One more, analytics. Where on the third position we have A, That's why we are getting a third position. So we put that here, 2_ and 3rd position belongs to any one of this character, and then any one of that letter, it's not a matter. So now we are getting that one. So I hope you understand this as well. So now I can remove this. I will put that comment now. Next question is that, where last characters is vowel, not the first. So now it's need to start with vowel, any character, but last characters will be vowel. So now, as we know that if we need that last character, then at the end we can put that all those letter whatever we want us to belong, and then percentile on the first one. Then it will give us all those letter where last one is end with A and U. So those belongs to vowels. So now if I go ahead and again put that cap, that it's not belongs to vowel, and if I can go ahead and run it, we can see now it's not coming those two. Rest all has started coming, right? So in this way, we can go and achieve all those, what all we needed now. Last one is that suppose I wanted to search something that belong from, start with some character and without any gap, it's need to go till some character, okay? So I think we, if we can put that, okay, we put like this, if we go with R, then what we going to get that output? Now let's see. So now we are getting only 3, okay, because A and R is there, there are no in between. So if I go and put till S, okay, so now if you put that S, run it. Now I am getting till S. If I go and put that T, if I will get all of them. If I put that now, go ahead and put that Z. It's not matter since we don't have, we get all those, like. So we have to put in this way if we wanted to go and see how this specific to some range, how it's going to work. So we need to put like this one. It's a start with A to R, okay? Start with A to R, okay. Now, sorry, my bad, this one, A to S, this one, A and R. Okay, so this one we can put that A to R, I told. So we can go ahead and put like this. Any letter. So we got this answer here. Now A comma R. So now in this one, what basically I tried to achieve it here. Sorry for this, I got it in the wrong way. So in this one, A comma R name start with only A and R, not any other characters. Now what I can do, I can put A or R and percent. So now if I go, we can see only 3 are coming, A and R. Now if I go ahead and put that start with T and R, then we'll get that those two names which start with R and one with that T. And if we go ahead and put that gap of, not this one, not a start with T and R, and if you run that, we'll get that all the other except which name I start with T and R. So I hope you understand this, how we can do that white card search, and you will be clear with that. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Thank you.